This film has been modified to fit your screen. The state of Massachusetts is filled with history everywhere you go, from the Bunker Hill Monument to the Parson Capon House. This film is a short documentary on the John Greenleaf Whittier home, home of one of America's most famous poets. The home itself was built in 1688 by John Greenleaf Whittier's great-great-grandfather Thomas Whittier. The home was built in a small pleasant valley under Jobs Hill and was perfect for a farming family at the time. John Greenleaf Whittier lived there from his birth in 1807 until 1836, where he moved to his new house in Amesbury. The Whittier family home was there for five generations until it opened up as a museum in 1894, just 2 years after John Greenleaf Whittier's death. It was bought by James H. Carleton in 1893 and donated to the Haverhill Whittier Club in 1894. John Greenleaf Whittier was introduced to poetry at an early age when his school teacher, Joshua Griffin, kept lending John a book called A Book of Poems by Robert Burns, a Scottish poet. Eventually, Joshua Griffin gave the book to young John Greenleaf Whittier as a gift. Every day, John would climb up into a tree and read and write poems where no one could find him or bother him. Eventually, John's older sister Mary caught on and took his poems and sent them to William Lloyd Garrison's free printing press in Newburyport. John's poems were shown in the newspaper. Luckily, his poems were well appreciated and encouraged him to keep writing. William Lloyd Garrison, who was the editor of the Newburyport Press and writer of The Abolitionist, encouraged Whittier to join the abolitionist cause. Many of John's first poems were against slavery, partially because of William Lloyd Garrison's literature, but mainly because John grew up in a Quaker family. John Greenleaf Whittier's work in the abolitionist cause was soon noticed, and he was invited to attend many local, state, and even national parties where he read and explained his poetry, as well as contributing to the formation of the Republican Party during the 19th century. After the Civil War ended in 1865, John's poems started reflecting on his early childhood and landscapes of Haverhill. Whittier had published some of these poems on the side, but were not recognized till the publication of Snowbound in 1866. The poem is a true story about a brutal storm in Haverhill, which kept the Whittier family nearly trapped in their house for a couple of days. Whittier explains in his poem how everyone joined together for warmth around the fire and told old stories about past memories. At first, the long poem was sent to children and hospitals and soon became a bestseller as soon as the public found out about it. Almost all of John Greenleaf Whittier's poems and volumes after Snowbound was published became bestsellers. John Greenleaf Whittier died at the age of 85 in 1892. He had a huge funeral where over 5,000 people attended from all over to say goodbye to the beloved poet. There were lots of people from Haverhill and neighboring towns, but what was really shocking was the amount of slaves who were there to pay respect to the man who helped free them.